Oh, gosh.
Welcome to the Bassin Guys Personal Video Journal. Representing over 40 years of fine-tuning patterns, techniques, and the art of power fishing to catch huge numbers of bass. So if you want to catch more bass in Central Florida, this is one angler who can show you some exciting ways to do just that.
Slow this morning, I can tell you that. They are not biting. I'm just kind of moving into the juice right now, so maybe that'll change. That's a nice chunker though. I like that size fish. All right, that's a start. That's a healthy one. He's hooked in the lower lip again, of course. Barely hooked too. Thank you. I guess if I'm not going to catch a bunch of them, that's the size to catch. That's a very fun size. And he was only 12, 15 feet at the most beside the boat. They're playing hard to get this morning. I've caught as many tilapia as I've caught bass. Hey, we got us one. A long time between bites. Yeah, I've run around to some different areas and tried some different things. We're back to where we started, and we got one. We might not get another one, but we got that one, doggone it. I thought I wasn't sure if I was ticking grass or if I was getting ticks on, you know, fish ticking it. I think it was fish. Strong. I don't think it's big, but it's strong. Oop. There we are. Thank you, my little friend. Well, if there's a bunch of fish ticking on this bait, maybe I'll get another one. All right. This for grins and giggles, since there seems to be some fish over there, as inactive as they are. Let's burn this thing through there a couple times to see what happens. There he is. What do you know? Feels like a better one too. It is. Burning it. Burning it. Most people would slow down when it's this tough. but you can trigger them just as easily burning it. It doesn't mean like I'm gonna catch a bunch of them doing that. I always did, my goal was just to maybe trick one or two. Well, let's see if we can do that again. That was fun. Boy, he loaded on it. And there's another one. Oh! That's a little bit bigger, actually. There he is. Oh. He got off. Jeez. You've seen me do this before. You know, burning a trap to try to trigger. No. Gosh, is that a fish? No. Oh, I thought that was a fish. It would have been a giant. Thing about doing this, unless the fish are like really, if they're really, you know, active, you can kind of keep doing this, but burning this bait through an area a handful of times, you can only get away with it so much sometimes before they say, uh-oh, we're not doing that again. Fool me once, right? That's fun when they hit this thing when you're burning it, though, I can tell you that. And this is a high speed reel too, 7.5 to 1. Okay, so prove the point. I would prove the point with the burn and the lipless. Now that they seem to be shut off from that, let's see if something slower will entice one. Well, just like that. So we proved a point with the burn in the trap, and now we're going to show them something else again. Right, they're starting to bite now. Now they are starting to bite. That's a chunker. Whoops. That's a chunker. What in the world? Oh, what in the world is this? Oh my gosh. That feels
I must have snagged a tilapia or something.
Uh-oh. Get away from the power pulse. What in the world? What in the world is this? You haven't seen it yet. I haven't seen it.
Catfish. Snagged the catfish in the back. No wonder.
No wonder.
Look at that. Oh, I thought that was the one.
That's not a catfish. That's not a catfish. Yeah.
Nose of the bait. There it goes. Nose of the bait was wedged in there. There. Just hooked in the roof of the mouth. No damage.
See, I can catch fish on a worm, fishing slow.
I don't prefer it, but I can do it. Sometimes, well, you just have to.
Had several bites on that cast, actually. Oh, I hear them. Yeah, I think we're in that bite window now. One of the frustrating parts of fishing with soft plastics like this worming for me is, you know,
the fish are active and you want to get a cast back out there, but a lot of times you have to, you know, straighten out your bait or put on a new bait like I did a few minutes ago, because I caught like two or three tiny ones that I didn't put on camera. Probably not as exciting to watch as topwaters or jerk baits or lipless. Ah, there's a chunker. There's a chunker. Nice. Wormfish. Oh my goodness gracious, what in the world? Holy. Another catfish, tilapia, what in the world is this? Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh. Oh, what in the world is this? Jeez. It's gotta be a tilapia. Golly, come back here. Oh, it's a nice bass by the tail. Oh my goodness. Was fighting like crazy. That's a 3+ pounder. This is gonna be interesting. I think I'll just get the pliers and unhook it. I'm not gonna try and get it in the boat, I don't think. This could be dangerous. This could be dangerous. Oh, there he goes. Oh my goodness gracious. Just keep working it. Just keep working it. Eventually, one will bite it. So you hope anyway. that chunker. There's that chunker. Fish. Middle of the day, but we're in the bite window and they're active. Hey, good things happen when you're in the bite window. The fact that I know I'm on them. I know I'm on the fish. Otherwise, I wouldn't do this. I'm worn out. Oh, it's so hot. I don't even know if one more is worth. Oh, there's a bite.
That will be the last one.
Oh, gosh. Hopefully they'll be here another day. Oh gosh. Alright, see you later, last one. I'm done. Thanks for watching. Don't know if you made it all the way through like I did, but we'll catch you next time.